You must be wondering, what can be a big struggle that you may have in CRNA school? Well, in this video, I'm gonna give you some great examples of what your struggles might be and how to overcome them. So keep watching. My name is Christine and welcome to a new video. If this is your first time here and you wanna become a CRNA, or grow your CRNA career, start now by subscribing and hitting the bell so you don't miss a thing. So you might be wondering, what are some struggles that I've had or what you might have when you're in school and how you can overcome them? Because I know you're in school or you wanna be in school as a CRNA and you're gonna go through these tribulations. And what are some ways you can overcome them? Because when you're in school, for being a CRNA, you've done all the hard work and sweat and struggle just to get into school. Now, how can you succeed? And how can you progress and be a strong person? Now, you might be in school, you might be in nursing school, or you might be in high school, you might be in another area right now, and you might be saying, what can I look out for as a struggle? And here, I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know because I'm here to help you succeed. I'm here to help you with your struggles because I remember when I was in school and I was struggling and I've learned some techniques that helped me. And I'm here to be honest and let you know that, you know, we're not all perfect and there's things that we can do to be better. And so definitely, here we go. One of my biggest struggles when I was in school, or even being a nurse in general, or CRNA in general, is being hard on myself. There are times when you're so hard on yourself, you feel like you want to be the best that you can, and somehow something, there's a wall that keeps, you keep pushing towards it and it keeps going against you. Well, I know it's just got to be confident. You just got to be positive. And you know what? If you're negative, the only thing that's going to happen is negativity. But when you're positive and you're trying your best to be positive and work towards a goal, there's options. You may be negative, you may be positive, but at least you have those options then versus being negative altogether. I always say be positive, you know, because at the end of the day, we want to succeed in whatever we're doing in life. And just remind yourself that you are a person that's going to work hard, you're going to be diligent, and you're not going to have anything that's going to stop you from succeeding in life. My new goal in life is, yes, I'm a CRNA. I love doing what I'm doing, but I'm here to teach you and encourage you to become a CRNA. And maybe becoming a CRNA may not be for you, but I'm here to encourage you to succeed and be successful in whatever you want to do in life. Because I know when I get older, maybe 10 years, 20 years from now, I want to be able to help you, help many people be successful in life and motivate you. So I want to inspire you to be a CRNA or be someone in the medical field, as well as motivate you to be strong and never give up on your passions and your goals in life, as well as thrive in your career. Because we all have things that are gonna be our struggle, but it's about our mindset. We have to try to take our mind and make it be positive, because I mean, there's always things that's gonna hold you down, but it's about being diligent, working hard, and keep pushing towards that future. Because remember, there's things in the past that maybe has not allowed you to be successful, but there's now, and there's your future that you can change. You can always change your future, but your past you may not be able to. But trying to think positive and try to inspire yourself, push yourself in a direction that's gonna help you, will allow you to be successful in any avenue in life. One of my big struggles when I was younger, not that I'm that old, but when I was younger, is my ego. My ego would always want me to be a certain way and think a certain way. I'd always try to compare myself to other people. And I've learned throughout the years, I've learned throughout life that forget about that ego. Just focus on the now. Focus on the moment. Focus on just being as good, as positive, as passionate as you can with anything in life. Because at the end of the day, it's about the positivity. It's about taking away those negative thoughts, because they're not gonna get you anywhere in life. They're just gonna hold you back. You don't want to be held back. You want to be inspired to be in a great road in life. You want to forget about all those negativity. If you have people in your life that are negative, just stay away from them. If there are certain actions that you are a part of that are negative, just change. Change it into a positive. Change it into something new. Because I'm not perfect. You're not perfect. We're human. But the great thing about being human, we are invincible in the sense that we can strike into a positive direction. We can change whatever feelings or negative thoughts that we have and make it into a positive one. And if you're having an experience that maybe you're in school and you're stressed and you're upset and you're like, what can I do to be better? Stop, take a breath, and just say to yourself, what can I do? And analyze the situation. What can I do to be a better person? What can I do to be a stronger person? What can I do to change the situation from a negative into a positive? You may be a nurse on the floor and saying to yourself, I want to become a CRNA. You may have some years under your belt of being an ICU nurse, and you've been trying to get into CRNA school, and somehow you're not getting accepted. It happens. It happens to everyone. And it may not be in the sense of going to school. Some people will get to school right away, while some other people might take a couple of times to be accepted into school. But it is important to analyze the situation. So I have some videos on ways to look at your application and look at some application mistakes that you may have done and how to fix them and to make it a better, stronger application. So if that's your case, definitely click the link above and check out that video. Because you might say to yourself, there are certain things. Maybe your grades are not the best at the moment. Maybe you haven't fulfilled all the requirements. Maybe your GRE scores are not the strongest. Maybe you didn't take your CCRM, which is a critical care certification in critical care. Maybe your ICU experience isn't the best. And maybe it's not the best in a sense that maybe you've gotten that experience, but it's not enough to allow you to become, to lay a foundation for CRNA school. So definitely think about switching things around. Retaking classes, retaking your GRE, taking a certificate in critical care, looking over your resume. Maybe your resume needs to be tightened. Maybe there's some activities that you need to be involved in. Maybe you need to do some research. Maybe you need to be a part of some kind of a committee in your hospital, or even be a part of a protocol in your hospital, as well as maybe be a part of quality improvement measures. Maybe be a champion. Maybe be a charge nurse. Those things show that you are a leader, and that you are in the right direction into trying to be a leader. Because as a CRNA, yes, we are advanced practice nurses, but at the same time, we are leaders. And you can be a leader as well. And yes, you may be a shy person and you may say to yourself, I'm more introverted. But leader can be in many avenues. We need people who are introverted. We need people who are extroverted to be leaders. Because at the end of the day, we all are not supposed to be the same. We're all supposed to be different and unique. And that's the beauty of nursing. It's the beauty of being a person in general in life. And so those are some things I would recommend you doing when you're thinking about some struggles. As well as maybe you're a CRNA and some things about your culture where you're working isn't for you. And yes, I've been in a situation where I've been in a facility where I wasn't the happiest. It may not be the people I'm surrounded with. Maybe it's the hours. Maybe it's, you may want, for example, for me, I want to focus more on my family. But at the same time, I love what I do, but I want to have time for my family. And I actually have achieved that. That's why I'm on YouTube right now. I have more than enough time to be here for you on YouTube, as well as be a part of my family's life. And for me, that was something that I needed to change. I needed to grow and see what other opportunities that are available to me. As a CRNA, our job is amazing, but at the same time, family for me is important. And so there are definitely ways that you can do that. Maybe the first couple of years you may work in an institution will be busy and fast paced, and then maybe in the future you want to convert into something more slower paced. But some people love the thrill and adrenaline that comes with certain facilities, and that's okay. But for me, like, I'm being honest with you, that's not for me anymore. I love what I'm doing now, and I love the place I'm working, I love the people I'm working with, but I do love my family, and that is important. So always remind yourself to be positive. You know, because we all struggle with everything, like I spoke to you about, to be honest with you. But there are struggles that we all have, and we have to stay positive. We have to try our best to move into a direction of positivity. So I'm here to inspire you. I'm here to motivate you, and I'm here to allow you to thrive in whatever career you want to be. But I would love you to become a CRNA just like me. But if you want to learn more about CRNAs and a career of being a CRNA, definitely click one of these videos over here. And this one over here is a playlist that you can go through a bunch of videos that can help you grow into becoming a CRNA. So definitely, I'll see you in the next video.